Man, when are we gonna write a song, man?
So it's time.
I'm thinking, I mean, I know you just put out a record. I just put out a record, so I don't know, but maybe.
That means it's time.
It's so time. I can't wait. I really can't wait. I did this thing called Song Exploder.
Oh, cool.
It's beautiful when something that you've been a part of, you're able to capture and people are able to see the intimacy.
Even for you to be able to watch it back and kind of appreciate what you do.
It was beautiful. And now you have a documentary as well. And how is that? Do you feel like that is super intrusive? Do you feel like you had to cut out a bunch of stuff because it was too much?
I had a director. I told him, like, just be there because I know I'm not going to want you in the room sometimes, but I want you to capture that because those are the real moments. But the hard part was editing, because when things start coming together, you start seeing the guy on the screen who looks amazing and sounds amazing and seems so caring and loving. But you also see the guy who's kind of a dick sometimes when he gets scared and gets frustrated. And you're like, I don't know if I want people to see that guy.
Yeah. So do you go for it?
You just got to let them see it. You have to let them see that vulnerability. And you and I both know the effort and love and passion and practice it takes to get to where we've gotten to, right?
Definitely. You know, I think the process is such a big thing. And a lot of people do want to see your process because it's so disjointed and it's so rugged and it's so like non-linear and it's mostly not that great.
You know? Yeah.
So, and that's the good part, I think. That's the part that makes it interesting.
In the documentary, there's a scene where, you know, the cameras came into my condo and I have this book of manifestations and whatever it is, from like I Sing High with no tension to my single went number one to I sold out the Rogers Center, which is the stadium back home. All that stuff, right?
Yes.
Which is amazing. Then I realized nothing in there said, I feel calm and happy in my body. I love myself. I am the best version. Nothing. And that was so funny because I found myself at this very high level of success, but very low level of internal success. And I think it gets romanticized to be like, I will be the greatest. I will be the biggest artist in the world. I will sell at the stadiums. Da, da, da. And it is magical. And there's nothing on this earth like that. But what needs to be more romanticized is that I love me, because that is what's really going to save you and make you feel whole.
Man, this has been so good. I'm so glad that we had this time to connect like this and just to hear where you are, and definitely looking forward. We're going to grab some. What's your favorite food?
I think I'm like really getting into like a Mediterranean type style food.
Mm. Okay, I'm into that. Yeah. I can do that because I like a lot of hummus.
We just eat hummus for 3 days straight.
I really love the person you are. And growing into.
I think I'm speaking for so many when I say that we appreciate you and we love you and we need you.
Oh, thank you. And we need you too.
Love you.